Proverbs chapter 10, verse 19. It says, "In the multitude of words there wanteth not sin, but he that refraineth his lips is wise." Ladies and gentlemen, this is part two of what the Spirit of the Lord told me to teach you, which was learn to be quiet. You know what time it is. Let's get it.
Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me?
Accepting the fact that my goal is the top, then knowing heaven is in that spot keeps driving me nonstop. Never allowing hell to defeat me. It's not possible as long as it's beneath me. Nothing sent from there could ever reach me.
What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? This is Apostle Makhario coming to you all again. And this is part two of the topic in which the Lord told me to teach you, which was learn to be quiet. Now, yesterday I gave you all Proverbs chapter 10, verse 19. It says, "In the multitude of words there wanteth not sin, but he that refraineth his lips is wise." Well, I left you with the video, and I said another scripture had come to me at the end of that video before I left the video. And I'm going to give it to you here. And that is 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verses 4, 5, and 6. It says, "For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalteth itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ, and having in a readiness to revenge all disobedience when your obedience is fulfilled." Well, one thing I want you all to understand is your words, what you speak out of your mouth, and the reason most people can't learn to be quiet is because they're constantly talking. And if you're constantly talking, you're not learning. If you're constantly talking, you're not able to process because you're constantly talking. So the understanding of the knowledge that you're gaining or the things that you're listening to, you won't actually grasp the concept. And if you don't understand something, there can be no wisdom from that, and you would consider it to be pointless, right? Or you just go about your way continuing to do your own thing like most of society, missing out on God and health and peace and righteousness and joy. Oh, Holy Spirit, I love you, Jesus. And all of those things that come along with because you're constantly talking. God wants us as a people to learn to be quiet. And in doing so, then God can teach you things. He can talk to you. He can download into your spirit. He can allow you to speak to people and you prophesy accurately. And you're not prophesying out of your flesh. He can do so many things through you when you learn to be quiet. But the Bible says in Proverbs 10:19, "In the multitude of words there wanteth not sin, but he that refraineth his lips is wise." People will know you by your ability to be quiet. People will know you by your ability to be wise if you learn to listen instead of just constantly talking. So with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, the Spirit of the Lord wanted me to take you here, which was 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 5. It says, 4, 5, and 6, "The weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imaginations, and every high thing that exalteth itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ." If you're constantly talking, and especially when you don't know what you're talking about, you're not bringing into captivity those thoughts to the obedience of Christ, right? Your imagination is running wild and you're just saying everything that flows out of your mouth. That's not the way God wants it to be. The other thing about that, and this ties into so many aspects in life, it ties into relationships, which I'm going to get into soon because someone asked me to teach on that. It ties into relationships. It ties into everyday life in general, not just spiritual things, but natural things. But remember, the closer you are to God in the spirit, the easier it is for you to navigate through this natural world, right? The easier it is for God to tell you, hey, if you go this way, there's going to be some trouble. So don't go that way. Go the other way. Literally, right? But it also ties into relationships. In Proverbs chapter 15, and this ties into all types of relationships, whether it be one of love or liking, but it also ties into your relationship with people and friendly and how people perceive you and how you really are, really, not just how they perceive you, but how you really are. This is how a person can know your heart if they don't know God enough to be able to know what's in your heart, discerning what's coming out of your lips. But Proverbs 15:1, it says, "A soft answer turneth away wrath, but grievous words stir up anger." So how do you know a person is wise if they're in an argument and they're flying off at the mouth just like the other person, and they're only arguing and saying things to hurt the other person, right? The Bible says a soft answer turneth away wrath, but grievous words stir up anger. If you want to diffuse a situation, you learn to be quiet, let the person speak. I know it's hard sometimes because they're lying on you. You learn to be quiet, you let the person speak, and then you answer. You don't have to say the first thing that comes to mind just because you know you're being lied on, or just because you know you're being talked about, whatever it may be, right? A soft answer turneth away wrath. If you're in a relationship with somebody, a marriage, and the person is flying off at the mouth, shh. Remember what I told you. I told you this many, many videos ago, many years ago. And that is, if you keep your peace while somebody's angry and you stay quiet, they can't continue to argue with themselves. Eventually, they're either going to stop or they're going to walk away and they're going to stay frustrated. But in doing so, God can fight the battle for you also. There's so many things that tie in to a person learning to be quiet that God wants to bless your life with. But until you learn to be quiet, God can't do it because you keep trying to fight your own battles. I've given you all so many instances, so many situations that happened to me in life where God said, don't say anything. And I didn't. And the Lord handled it, and he handled it better than I could have. Trust and believe. And that same thing could happen for you. Let me take you here as well, because it's, I love you, Jesus, because it's so important for you to get this. This is how important it is for people to learn to be quiet. You go to Joshua chapter 6, and this is when the children of Israel were supposed to go up and take Jericho, the city of Jericho. And you know what the Lord told them to do? He told them to be quiet for 6 days and walk around the city. And on the seventh day, after you walk around, open your mouth and shout. Now, here's where many of you would have lost the battle from the beginning. Because you, first of all, you would not have obeyed the word of God, which was just to walk around the city walls once a day. And then on the seventh day, composite, you know. So many of you would have just failed right then and there. So you never would have taken that city. But for most people, they would have failed in not being quiet as they walked around the city. And on top of that, keeping their mind in the right place during that walk. See, most people, especially in society, they have to talk because they feel like what they have to say is the most important thing in the world, and it's not. So for many of you, even those of you that claim to be Christian, you have to speak. You just feel the need to speak. You feel the need to have noise. You feel the need to all of these things, and that's not where God operates. God doesn't operate in constant noise and you running your mouth. God doesn't operate there. You're not going to hear his voice clearly if you're constantly talking. You're looking for a solution to your problem, but your mouth is constantly running, and God can't give you a solution because you won't shut up. So many of you would have lost the battle here when the Lord said, walk around the city, because you would not have been able to be quiet. You would have had to make some noise. Let's go here. Joshua chapter 6. Oh boy. Starting at verse 1. It says, now Jericho was straitly shut up because of the children of Israel. None went out and none came in. And the Lord said unto Joshua, see, I have given into thine hand Jericho and the king thereof and the mighty men of valor. And ye shall compass the city, all ye men of war, and go round about the city once. Thus shalt thou do 6 days. Pay attention. And 7 priests shall bear before the ark 7 trumpets of ram's horns. And the seventh day ye shall compass the city 7 times, and the priests shall blow with the trumpets. And it shall come to pass that when they make a long blast with the ram's horn, and when ye hear the sound of the trumpet, all the people shall shout with a great shout, and the wall of the city shall fall down flat, and the people shall ascend up, every man straight before him. So the Lord said, I want you to walk around the city. He said, once a day, and be quiet the whole time you're walking around the walls of Jericho. This is what the Lord told the children of Israel. And that's where many of you would have lost the battle, because you would have had to say something. You would have had to say something, because that's how society operates. Many people in society don't know how to be quiet, and that's why their situation can't get handled by God. Many people in the church don't know how to be quiet. That's why God can't talk to them, and they live 50 years in the church, and they never grow. Because God is like, I need you in a place of silence. I need you to get away from certain people. And many people are like, no, Lord. They're talking back to God instead of listening to God. And this is where the problem lies. And so, like God told the children of Israel with the walls of Jericho, compass the city round about 6 days and don't say a word. And on the seventh day, then after the trumpets blow, I want you to shout. And in doing so, the walls of the city will fall down and you can go win this fight. Right? So let's go here to Joshua chapter 6, verse 20 and 21, because I want to show you what happened. It says, So the people shouted, this is on the seventh day, after they compassed the city, they stayed quiet, and this is the only reason that God allowed it to happen the way it happened. It says, Joshua chapter 6, verse 20, so the people shouted when the priests blew with the trumpets. And it came to pass, when the people heard the sound of the trumpet, and the people shouted with a great shout, that the wall fell down flat, so that the people went up into the city, every man straight before him, and they took the city. It says here in verse 21, and they utterly destroyed all that was in the city, both man and woman, young and old, and ox and sheep, and ass with the edge of the sword. So ladies and gentlemen, they obeyed God, which was they stayed quiet those 6 days while God told them to be quiet. Even on the seventh day, they had to be quiet as they walked around. And after the trumpets blew, they were able to open their mouth and shout. And it was a shout of victory. And guess what happened? After that shout of victory, they went in and they literally took the city. Only because they learned to be quiet and to obey God in his commandments. I told you, there will be times where God will tell you to speak. There will be other times where God will tell you to be quiet so he can fight the battle for you. Or in being quiet, God can give you what to say. Remember, Jesus, I love you, Jesus. Oh my goodness. Matthew chapter 10, verse 20. Jesus said this. Verse 19, let's go. Actually, let's go to verse 18. Matthew chapter 10, verse 18. It says, and ye shall be brought before governors and kings for my sake, for a testimony against them and the Gentiles. But when they deliver you up, take no thoughts how or what ye shall speak, for it shall be given unto you in the selfsame hour what ye shall speak. Guess what? It cannot be given unto you if you're speaking. It can only be given unto you if you're quiet and listening to what God wants you to say. Verse 20, for it is not ye that speak, but the Spirit of your Father which speaketh in you. God can't speak in you if you're not quiet to hear his voice. The Lord said you're going to be brought before judges and governors and kings. And if you're not quiet to hear God's voice, if you don't learn to be quiet to hear his voice and to be able to discern properly what he wants to tell you when you're brought before those governors and kings and priests, then you won't know how to answer. And that's the problem with so many people. In the church especially, God wants you to learn to be quiet. Let's go here. I got to give you this. I love you, Jesus. I laughed earlier in the video because the Spirit of the Lord brought this verse to me. Because it's so important that you all understand this. Isaiah, I love you, Jesus. 32:17. The Bible says in Isaiah 32:17, and the work of righteousness shall be peace, and the effects of righteousness, quietness and assurance forever. See, the Lord wants you to understand, you work righteousness by being quiet. And the Bible says, and the work of righteousness shall be peace, and the effect of righteousness is what? Quietness and assurance forever. See, in your quietness, people know that you're assured of what you're talking about. But when you're quick to just say stuff, and you don't learn to be quiet to discern his voice, to hear what God has to say to you. You don't learn to be quiet in order to respond, but you fly off because you get angry quickly. You don't have that effect of righteousness, right? You don't have that assurance. And people know that you don't have that assurance because they know that they got you. Satan knows. You got to understand, there's a spirit of anger. There's a spirit of murder. There's a spirit of wrath. These are demonic spirits. I've dealt with anger. I've dealt with fear, all of these things. And many times even people have to speak because they speak out of fear. They're afraid, what are people going to think about me if I don't say anything back? Well, what if you do say something back and you speak too fast and you put yourself in more trouble, which is normally what happens for most people? Instead of them processing and listening, they lose the battle because they speak too quickly. The Bible says, and the work of righteousness, Isaiah 32:17, the work of righteousness shall be peace, and the effect of righteousness, quietness, and assurance forever. Remember, what happened when Jesus was brought before the council? And they were saying all these things against them, and it says they couldn't even bring two together, because remember, out of the mouth of two or three witnesses shall everywhere be established. That was how people were supposed to be killed also, out of the mouth of two. But their witness had to agree one with another. And the whole time, their witness never agreed. Jesus never said a word. He went before so many people and didn't say anything. And then what happened when the gentleman said, "I adjure you by God"? That's when he spoke. So he's saying, you know, you're going to command me, or you're going to tell me to speak by me. So now I have to speak for me. But he learned to be quiet that whole time. The Lord didn't have to respond. One more. Jesus has given me so many more. One more verse. And I'm going to end you with the words of Jesus like I always do. And that is Matthew chapter 15. Because I really want you to get this. In you learning to be quiet and discern God's voice and spending time in his presence. Once again, I told you yesterday, you can't spend time in God's presence if you're constantly talking. You can pray, but prayer is not only speaking to God, it's learning to listen. It's a conversation. So after you pray and you say what you need to say, listen to what God needs to say to you. Matthew chapter 15, we'll start at verse 10. It says, "And he called the multitude and said unto them, Hear and understand. Not that which goeth into the mouth defileth the man, but that which cometh out of the mouth, this defileth the man." Pay attention. Not what goes in, what comes out. That's the first thing Jesus said. Verse 12, "Then came his disciples and said unto him, Knowest thou that the Pharisees were offended after they heard this saying?" It's okay, people will be offended at the truth. Verse 13, "But he answered and said, Every plant which my heavenly Father hath not planted shall be rooted up. Let them alone, they be blind leaders of the blind, and if the blind lead the blind, both shall fall into the ditch. Then answered Peter and said unto him, Declare unto us this parable. And Jesus said, Are ye also yet without understanding? Do not ye understand that whatsoever entereth in at the mouth goeth into the belly and is cast out through the draught, or cast out into the draught? But those things which proceed out of the mouth come forth from the heart. They defile the man." Hear what Jesus said in Matthew 10 and 18. "But those things which proceed out of the mouth cometh forth from the heart, and they defile the man." Verse 19, "For out of the heart proceed evil thoughts, murders, adulteries, fornications, thefts, false witness, blasphemies. These are the things which defile a man, but to eat with unwashing hands defileth not a man." But get what Jesus said. He said this, verse 18 and 19. He said, "But those things which proceed out of the mouth come forth from the heart, and they defile the man. For out of the heart proceed evil thoughts, murders, adulteries, fornications, thefts, false witness, and blasphemies." Those things. So that's why I tell you, you have to learn to be quiet. Because as I told you in Proverbs chapter 10, verse 19, it says, "In the multitude of words there wanteth not sin, but he that refraineth his lips is wise." When you talk too much, the Bible says, sin doesn't lack in your multitude of words. I gave you the other verse in Ecclesiastes. It talks about a fool is known by his multitude of words. So you have to learn to be quiet to discern God's voice. You have to learn to be quiet to respond. Don't be quick to open your mouth and speak. A lot of preachers out there, and I'm telling you, you guys know I've been around for a long time in the churches. My parents were pastors. So a lot of people out there speaking and teaching things that are not godly because they don't listen. They don't know what they're talking about. Okay, Lord. they don't know what they're talking about, and they're talking and they're teaching things that are, as the Bible says, they're blasphemies. There's false witnesses of who God is. They teach people so many other things that are not of God because they're constantly talking and never listening to God's voice. They think they know, and they have no idea. Literally. I love you all. I will see you all again soon. I feel like the Spirit of the Lord is telling me to do a part three to this. So we're going to do a part three to this. Learn to be quiet. See you all again soon. May God bless. We are out.
Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me?
Accepting the fact that my goal is the top, then knowing heaven is in that spot, keeps driving me nonstop. Never allowing hell to defeat me. It's not possible as long as it's beneath me. Nothing sent from there could ever reach me.